think of the most wonderful experience of your life. Now, imagine if life could be as good as that, or rather, imagine if life could be better than that all the time. Just imagine if your best experience ever could be lower than tomorrow's hedonic floor. Other things being equal, wouldn't it be better if we could live in paradise? Now, for much of history, this kind of talk would be could be dismissed as simply utopian dreaming, that manipulating the environment in innumerable different ways has been tried, and to be honest, we're not significantly happier now than our ancestors on the African savannah, certainly not if suicide, depression, marital breakup statistics, etc., are taken seriously. However, thanks to biotechnology now, it will be possible to re-engineer ourselves, to edit our own source code, to enjoy life animated by gradients of bliss. Other things being equal, doesn't it make sense to make that our default option? What could go wrong? Well, lots of things could go wrong, but that's true of any experiment, and that's what having kids involved today, when two people decide to bring children into the world, chances are at the moment they're going to be bringing an awful lot of suffering into the world too. Whereas in future, when one creates new life, one will be creating, or at least potentially creating, gradients of lifelong well-being. And if we're ethically serious, that's the approach I think we ought to be taking. I think a lot of people will probably think, well, that's all well and good. Maybe our children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren will enjoy this kind of fabulous life. What about me now? Because we're human, one can listen to these wonderful tales, some futurists relate of how good life could be in future, a future of super intelligence, super longevity, super happiness, all these wonderful things. What about now? One still has bills to pay, taxes, relationship problems, just the messy nitty-gritty reality of life. Unfortunately, I don't have a panacea now, or rather the kinds of interventions one can suggest. Good diet, exercise, sleep discipline, unfortunately, are not as exciting as this tantalizing prospect that our children and grandchildren will enjoy. But after that somber note, perhaps it's worth suggesting that with designer drugs and in future autosomal genetic therapy, it will be possible for adults, people of my age and older, to enjoy the best time of their lives too. Perhaps not full-blown paradise engineering of the richness that our descendants may enjoy, but there is no reason to be sceptical that the later years of our life won't be incomparably richer than anything that's gone before.